Today we're going to finally understand the different types of RAW files available to you in your Fujifilm camera. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. Many of you shoot in RAW format, and in fact, RAW format is so important to photography that there are literally hundreds of videos on the subject, including mine, link in the description below. Unlike a JPEG, a RAW file is not an image file at all. It's like a big container of data that represents your camera's sensor and what was recorded at the moment you took the shot. You cannot see or read a RAW file as an image. You need a program like Photoshop, Lightroom, Capture One, etc., that can understand how to read and convert this raw data, because you always end up converting it into something that you can see and edit visually. And usually this means converting it into a TIFF, DNG, or JPEG file. Now, many Fujifilm cameras offer you two different types of RAW compression, uncompressed or lossless compressed. And the launch of the X-T4 camera introduced the new compressed option. You choose it right here in the IQ section under RAW recording, and you have three choices right here. It's important for you to understand that there are two types of compression: lossless compression and lossy compression. And the goal of both types of compression is to make your image file sizes smaller. Now, with the first type, lossless compression, the camera is retranslating various parts of the image. So for example, if you have an image with blue sky, you know, right here, instead of the raw file saying one blue pixel here, 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 and so forth, it will simply say 10 blue pixels here. It's kind of like I could tell you that my blood pressure is going up, I'm clenching my fist, I'm gritting my teeth, I've got blood rushing to my face, I'm just kind of like this, or I'm pissed off, right? Two ways to say the same thing. Now, the important takeaway from this is that nothing is discarded. And in theory, your image quality should be exactly the same between an uncompressed RAW file or a lossless compressed RAW file. Now, with the second type of compression, lossy compression, the camera does throw away image data. And it takes into account what the human eye can see, and it does this by, among other things, reducing the amount of color components in the image. I'm being really simple here with this, but you get the idea. What's important for you to remember is that once you save a file that's been compressed with lossy compression, and then you open it back up and you save it again, you kind of get sort of a generation loss. Just like a JPEG file, that if you open a JPEG file up in Photoshop, and then open that JPEG again, and then save it again, each time you do this, the image quality will get worse and worse and worse. Okay, so going back now to Fujifilm RAW files. On the X-T4 camera, you can choose either uncompressed, lossless compressed, or compressed. And again, the first two, uncompressed and lossless compressed, do not discard any image data. The last one, compressed, does. But how much data? And can you really notice it with regard to image quality? First off, look at the file sizes between these three types of files. The uncompressed RAW file is 57.4 megabytes. That's the largest one of all. Lossless compressed is 27.6 megabytes. That's 52% less file size than the uncompressed RAW. And compressed RAW is 26.4 megabytes, which is very similar to lossless compressed at about 54% less file size. So right off the bat, these file size differences are going to affect how fast your camera both fills its buffer as well as how fast your camera can clear that buffer and save to the SD card. So I shot a series of test photos where I put the camera on continuous high. Then I went ahead, put an SD card in here, and held down the shutter release, you know, to shoot as many as I could to see how fast it takes to fill the buffer and also how long it takes to save and clear out the buffer and save to the SD card. It took 3.37 seconds to fill the camera's buffer with uncompressed RAW files. It took 3.86 seconds to fill it with lossless compressed, and it took 4.8 seconds to fill it with compressed RAW files. Then I decided to test taking 10 shots and seeing how long it would take for 10 shots to write to the SD card, right? So with uncompressed raw files, it took 5 seconds to write from the camera to the SD card. With compressed lossless, it took 3.5 seconds. And with regular compressed raw files, it took 3 seconds. So there's no doubt about it. It takes a shorter amount of time to fill the camera's buffer and a longer amount of time to write to the SD card when shooting uncompressed raw files versus compressed. But what about after you get the files off of your SD card and bring them into Lightroom or Capture One? I ran a test where I imported 100 raw files straight into Lightroom. I did this in 3 batches, one for uncompressed, one for lossless compressed, and one for compressed. All the conditions were the exact same. I used a Mac Mini with 32 gigs of RAM. I also set the preview size to auto and the preview quality to medium. So bringing 100 raw files into Lightroom to the point where the previews were rendered took 4 minutes and 4 seconds uncompressed, 4 minutes and 43 seconds lossless compressed, and 4 minutes and 12 seconds compressed. Now, the great news was that once they were imported, Lightroom was able to read and display and edit all 3 raw compression file types with no trouble at all. Same with Capture One. All 3, no issues. And all 3 even worked with Photo Mechanic. In addition, Iridient X Transformer also had no trouble with any of them in converting them over to DNG files. But what about image quality? Let's take a look at that. The image on the left is uncompressed and the image on the right is compressed. If I zoom in all the way to 100%, I don't see a difference in color rendering. I don't see a difference in noise. Heck, I don't even see a difference in the number of worms that appear in Lightroom. The same thing with uncompressed versus lossless compressed. I couldn't see any difference between the two at all. And in fact, going to the develop module and flipping through each image was speedy, whether it was uncompressed or whether it was compressed. The performance in Lightroom was the same for all 3 compression types. Same thing in Capture One. I have all 3 of them here and they look identical. No difference whatsoever. Same thing with Luminar. No difference. Next, I shot a photo that was 5 stops underexposed. Let's see if there's any difference in bringing back that exposure from the raw file based on the compression type. So for each one of these, all I'm going to do is drag the exposure slider all the way up so that it's 5 additional stops of exposure in post-production. Everything else is zeroed out here. Let's do it for the lossless compressed, and finally for the compressed. Let's now compare uncompressed with compressed, you know, the 2 most extreme. Identical. No difference at all. Again, the noise is the same, the colors are the same, the amount of exposure I was able to bring back, identical. And finally, I shot a photo that was 3 stops overexposed. Let's see what happens with the highlight details. So for the uncompressed raw, let's bring it down 3 stops. You see that? Let's do the same for lossless compressed. And finally for the compressed. And exactly the same level of highlight detail is there. No difference. Absolutely none. So pretty boring so far, right? I could not find any difference between these 3 different compression types in terms of image quality. However, there was one bit of difference that I did find, and that was with the Iridient X Transformer software in converting an uncompressed versus a compressed raw file into a DNG. Check this out. I ran all 3 files through Iridient using exactly these settings right here, which were the default settings when you install the software. But have a look at this when I zoom into 800%. Look at the photo on the right, the compressed. Do you see the difference that you have this additional purple fringing color? Look at that. You see that? These photos were shot exactly the same. And as you saw in the other demos, they looked identical. But when they were run through Iridient and then brought in here, there was a huge difference between compressed and uncompressed. This is amazing. Look at the difference in detail. I gotta be honest with you, I think the compressed file actually looks a bit better. And here the compressed file on the edges is less sharp than the uncompressed DNG. See that? I am zoomed in at 800%. Just keep that in mind. If I zoom back out to 100%, it's very difficult to see the difference. But again, this area right here, if I zoom in to 800%, look at that. And I think a lot of this has to do with how how raw files are translated by various software applications. If the raw file was originally compressed, it's different than if the raw file was uncompressed, and there's a different handling of it, as you can see here. But interestingly, when you open up the raw files straight up in Capture One and you don't convert them to a DNG, it looks identical. So here's the question of the day. What raw compression file type should you shoot with? First off, if you're not shooting client work and you're just shooting for fun or hobby, then I would suggest using lossless compressed. Now, while I personally did not see any difference between shooting uncompressed or compressed raw files, I cannot recommend ever to my viewers to shoot in any kind of image type that would throw away data that you can never get back. File storage is getting cheaper all the time. But just know that if you do decide to shoot compressed, I did not find any noticeable difference in image quality between compressed and uncompressed raw files in any of the major raw conversion software programs. But keep in mind that things change, especially in how software translates raw files. And what I'm telling you today could change in the future regarding file compression. Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the video helpful. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will see you in another video again very soon. Take care.